modern or vintage. It doesn't matter to Filipino fashion designer Jor-el Espina, who is in the limelight on the fashion scene for his modern take on traditional Filipino fashion. This young and promising designer is one of the Filipino talents who take pride in the country's classic fabric, barong. And his masterpiece, bamerong, is the new fashion trend you will definitely go crazy over.
The idea of a bamerong is a portmanteau of a barong and a bomber jacket. It's like telling the market that we cannot just wear barong in a formal occasion, but we can wear barong every day. The fabric that I usually use for the bamerong is the traditional barong. We searched that material from Taal, Lumban, and Aklan. So these are the famous barong makers in our country. I started in the fashion industry when I was in my 20s. Ever since when I was young, I really want to be a fashion designer. I keep an eye always for the nice colors, the nice fabrics, the nice textures and prints. My main goal and vision as a designer is, of course, to spread the story of our tradition in a modern voice, like telling people that we still have a lot of beautiful fabrics around the Philippines. We still have a lot of beautiful crafts all over our country that we have to celebrate. My last fashion show was in my province. It's in Iloilo. So we were like almost 15 young designers. The last show I did here in Manila was last October, which is the Manila Fame. And there are upcoming fashion shows here in the Philippines and abroad for the next few months. Fashion designing is not just a walk in the park. In the fashion industry, making a mark is important. We have a lot of potential talents in our country. All we need to do is to love our work, love our craft, and we have to respect also the craft of each other.
Jor-el's genuine efforts in incorporating culture in everyday life proves that he's definitely the bomb.
Hashtag fashion is life. That's the case for John Herrera, who has reached new heights with his recent success at the London Fashion Week and Britain's Top Design Competition.
I love my work, but to be honest with you, the one thing we cannot control is how people will perceive our work. I wanted to show them that there's a wearable possibility to my collection, my fabrics, and I was wearing it. So I wanted it to be me, but the next thing I was praying for is that if it's not me, allow me to accept it, you know, wonderfully, graciously, poised. But I really wanted to win. Not only wanted, actually, I needed to win. So before joining Fashion Scout, I actually participated at the International Fashion Showcase, sponsored by the British Fashion Council in 2015. But before the Fashion Scout thing, I felt like I was still under the radar, or sort of not catching the eyes of mainstream media people. This is officially my fifth show. I keep track of this because of the challenges, especially the financial challenges a young designer faces.
We also took a peek into the designer's atelier and got to ask why he chose to showcase the Philippine Eagle in his designs for the collection this season.
Everything's been done. So I thought I should bring something from my country, which is something that's me, that's personal, and something that is amazingly abundant in our islands. So yeah, I brought the Aguila, and they loved it. London is not a place for you to blend in. It's not one of those places if you really want to make something out of yourself and your career. It's a place to stand out.
So what's next for John Herrera?
Right now, the excitement is building up, but I don't know what will happen. Whatever happens though, something that I'm sure about myself is that I will forever be grateful. I will forever take everything on a gain perspective. It's either you win or you learn something. That's always been my motto in everything that I do.
We'll definitely be watching closely to find out what the future has in store for this designer.